Alright folks, it is time for a gimbal moves tutorial. Today I'll show the 5 basic gimbal moves Peter McKinnon used in the DJI RS2 Blow Our Minds video. This video is a great example of what you can achieve with just a standard gimbal together with great cinematography and good editing. But with that said, I will also point out some of the mistakes that I see Peter do while operating the gimbal. This is a great opportunity to show you how you can get a similar shot using these basic gimbal moves. So, here we go. So as I said, let's take a look at the gimbal moves that was used in the DJI RS2 video. Just to fill you in a bit here, Peter and Kirk made a BTS video of how they created the DJI Blow Our Minds video. But that was more of a how they shot it and the editing side of things. They didn't really talk about what gimbal moves and techniques they used to get those shots. And it might look super difficult, but in general they only used 5 basic gimbal moves cut very well together. And then they have one more technical jib looking shot done with the gimbal hanging from a line, but you can achieve a similar shot just using an extension pole. Then they also used the Raven Eye here to auto track their talent while operating the gimbal. This is a great way to get some of those shots where the operator can't see the framing because he's either too far away from the gimbal or he's running at full speed trying to catch up with the talent. Alright, let's just move on to the gimbal setup, which is right here. Alright, let's briefly go over their gimbal setup. So they used the RS2 because this was a video made for this gimbal particular. So they had it in this basic configuration. They didn't use the side arm, which I'm using a lot with the monitor on top, but they had this back arm where you can use, which you can use to put into briefcase mode. So this is a nice addition. So they used it very, very standard. And then of course they used the Raven Eye a lot to frame up their shots. But just remember one thing, you don't need the RS2 to get these shots. If you have a Weeble S, Crane 2S, Moser Air, whatever gimbal you have, you can get these shots. So let's take a look at the first gimbal move right here. All right, so the first one we're gonna take a look at is a push-in shot. And what is that? A push-in shot is where you're pushing forward with the gimbal, revealing something or pushing forward to your subject. And Peter and his crew used this technique kind of a handful of times during out this video, and we'll show some of them here. We can see they're pushing in on the subject, or they're just moving fast forward and panning towards the subject. So this one here is a push and a pan in the end, but it's still the same move. Push forward with your gimbal nice and slowly and you'll get a nice looking shot. All right, so then to the mistake that Peter made in this video, and I know they only made this shot to showcase the transition from the big Ronin 2 2D RS2 gimbal to see the big difference in how big of a setup the one is to the other. But the way Peter is walking with the gimbals is way off. You cannot walk with a gimbal for a long time the way he walks. As you can see in this shot here where he's walking with the Ronin 2, he's bent forward with his upper body and he's also bent a bit too much down in his knees trying to create that ninja walk to walk smoothly. He probably does get a good shot, but if he had to work like that for a long time, he would destroy his knees and his lower back. And you can see as soon as we transition to the next shot where the RS2 comes into the scene, this is even worse because then Peter is totally bent over, and this way he also does just a straight pushing shot, very bent over, and it's a very bad position to be walking in. Instead, you want to be standing up straight, and then you can still hold the gimbal low if you want the low shot, but stand up straight and then walk forward in a straight line using the heel to toe to create a nice smooth shot. So Peter, please don't do this anymore because you will hurt your lower back and you will hurt your knees if you keep shooting on a gimbal like this. Let's get on to the next one. All right, the next one here is a parallax shot, which is probably one of my favorites when done correctly. So what is a parallax shot? That is when you're moving your gimbal around a subject, then you can see the background is moving the opposite direction of where the gimbal is moving, creating what you call a parallax. It's a super cool move, and this is probably the main shot that they used throughout this video, cut seamless together. And as we can see in these clips here, they keep moving around their talent, creating this parallax effect. And they keep moving in the same direction so they can stitch all these clips together. So this is the main gimbal move that they have used throughout this video. Then we got side tracking, and this one is super interesting because they're tracking this guy running through the forest, and then we got Peter running full speed pointing the gimbal to the side, and then they cut to the BMX rider as well. So the way that side tracking works is that you take your gimbal and then you point it at the direction you want to film. Let's say the talent is you, and then I lock the gimbal, turn it 90 degrees, and the camera and the gimbal will keep pointing in your direction. But I will be facing forward, being able to monitor my shot while I'm walking in a straight line, filming you on the side. This is how they made this shot in the video. And when you see the clip, it's very stable, and I'm pretty sure that they have used some kind of post stabilization to these clips because Peter's running full speed and there will be some bumps and jitters in that footage, but they've smoothed it out very nicely in the post production. So another note to take here is that they are using the Raven Eye to track the talent so that the operator don't have to worry about that while he's running through the forest. All right, that is sidetracking. Let's move on to the next one. Then we got the follow shot, and this is also a very basic gimbal move. All you do is that you frame up your subject or your talent, and then you follow them from behind. Try to keep the same distance so they won't get out of focus. You can do the same in reverse, just walk backwards while you are tracking or following your subject. And if we look at the video, they only use this move a couple of times. Two times down in the tunnels, and then one following the BMX rider. And a good note to take here is that they're using a set of wheels whenever they can to better stabilize the gimbal and smooth out some of that up and down movement that will occur if you don't walk correctly while operating your gimbal. All right, then we have the last two gimbal moves here, and that is they have some pans in there and then also a raise up. They are very subtle, but they are in there. And then they cooked all this together with some great BTS footage, which I love that they put in there. And then of course, some great handheld shots. And then this one, which I love, is just Levi swinging down from the ceiling, hitting the floor. And yeah, if you don't know this guy, go check out his channel. Great, great filmmaker. And with that said, we'll have to look at the last one, which is the jib shot. All right, let's take a look at how they made this jib looking shot possible. So they're using the Raven Eye to control the gimbal. And as you can see, they have it on the line extended from above. And then they got Levi on top pulling the camera up and someone else pulling the camera back, creating this jib looking shot. It's very creative and it works very, very well. But if you don't have the option to do something like this and have someone like Levi crawl up and rig all this up and make this happen, you can just use an extension pulley. These comes in a variety of formats. The one that I use the most is these carbon fiber ones that I just screw onto the bottom here of the gimbal and extend them out. If you just connect these, then you can get them as long as you want. But you can also use a monopod. This one here is the monopod from Shuin, which is really good to extend your gimbal up high up in the air. And as you can see in this clip here, where I've extended the gimbal out fully on the monopod and just creating this shot going into this train. But you can use this in a lot of ways, and it's a very effective tool. And you can use any monopod out there as long as you can screw it onto the bottom of your gimbal. All right, so these are the five basic gimbal moves plus that jib shot that they used in this RS2 video. I hope you learned something from this video. And of course, if you want to learn more about gimbals, you can always sign up for my Gimbal Academy. You'll find the link down in the description. All right, guys, I don't have any more for you. If this is the first time you're here, remember to subscribe if you want to learn more about filmmaking with motion. And of course, stay creative and stay safe. And if you can, go out and shoot some dope videos. See you next time. Bye.